Mrs. Baxendale!
Which one?
Amanda Krista.
Look, E.T.
I didn't know he was
E.T. Mom!
Believe it or not, you're looking at a classroom. This group of students is spending a day at a Newfoundland farm. It's a neat way to learn where all the potato chips come from, hey? Still, it's a long way from these fields to the dinner table. These young people are going to find out a bit about farming, an important industry in our province. Millions of potatoes have grown on these fields. It's hard to imagine that this farm was once a wilderness. So how was the land changed from forest to field? How did farming begin in Newfoundland? To answer such questions, we must go way back in time to the days when our ancestors set out on the long, hazardous voyage across the Atlantic Ocean. The first sight of the Newfoundland must have been quite a shock. Rocky shores, towering cliffs. Nothing like the rolling fields they left back home in England and Ireland. Yes, the land was poor, but that didn't matter, for they came to fish, not to farm. The sea would be their garden. And a rich garden it was. Schools of fish swarmed about the Newfoundland. Codfish even came in close to shore, chasing the capelin. These waters were surely the richest in the world. It was difficult, however, to live on a diet of fish alone. Eventually, when settlement began, people turned to the land to try and see if they could grow their own crops. It wasn't easy, for the soil was thin and rocky. Before long, however, the settlers discovered that they could use fish and kelp from the sea to improve the land. They spread it on the ground, dug it into the soil, and it became a rich fertilizer. Gradually, vegetables began to grow. It was the beginning of farming in our province. Some people continue to farm the way our ancestors did, with little kitchen gardens out back of the house, growing just enough for their family's use. Mostly, though, today's farming is done on a big scale. Farms are large and highly specialized. And work once done by hand is now done by expensive machinery. Vegetable farming begins in the spring, or as soon as the frost leaves the ground and the sun begins to warm the soil. First, the land must be plowed, the soil turned over and loosened. Limestone is often added, for our soils are normally too acid or bitter for good growth. Limestone sweetens the soil and encourages earthworm and insect movement, which helps break up the soil. Next, fertilizers are added. Oh, not the fish that people used years ago. Today's fertilizer is very different stuff indeed. It's manufactured by large chemical companies and comes in the form of tiny granules. Actually, it's a mixture of the essential ingredients for plant growth, the three main ones being nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Science is very much a part of agriculture today. Scientists are constantly at work breeding new varieties of plants for Newfoundland's growing conditions. They analyze soil samples. They study and try to find ways to control plant diseases. Generally speaking, scientists help farmers to solve their problems. Growth on the farm, like growth anywhere, begins, of course, with the seed. Some, such as these carrot seeds, are quite tiny. Others are quite large. The eye of the potato is used like a seed. Farmers simply cut old potatoes into sections, each containing a potato eye. From each eye, a new potato plant will grow. Now, the old way was to plant potatoes by hand, using capelin, or in this case, kelp, as fertilizer. The modern way is to plant by machinery. This potato planter can plant thousands of potatoes an hour. It drops the potato pieces evenly and then covers them with soil. There's always a danger of frost at planting time, and some farmers get a jump on Mother Nature by starting the plants indoors. They transplant them outside in the fields when all danger of frost is gone. With sun and rain and time, they grow. But so do the weeds. Weeds must be eliminated from the fields, or they'll choke or slow down the growth of the crops. A lot of weeding is done by hand. With some crops, it can be done by machinery. Often, farmers apply chemicals to control the weeds and insects. This is especially important on large farms. With constant care and attention, the plants grow. And grow. And grow. By early fall, it's time to begin the harvest. This is the busiest time of year for the vegetable farmer. Crops must be taken out of the ground before the frost and the snow comes. They must be washed and graded and packaged and eventually taken to market. There's a lot of work to be done, and the whole family must pitch in. A farmer always hopes for a good crop, for a good price. And some years are good, but some years are not. Farming is a bit of a gamble. But there's more to it than luck. There's patience and hard work and skill. Scientific skill and the skill learned from experience. Of course, there's satisfaction too. Satisfaction in knowing that they've succeeded in making this rough land of ours yield such a rich harvest. Meet Elsie Rebecca Gladstone III. That's her official name, but you can just call her Elsie. Elsie and her sisters are dairy cows. This is just one of the many herds of dairy cows in Newfoundland and Labrador. And together, these herds produce millions of liters of milk per year. The cows are brought to the barn twice a day to be milked, morning and evening. No longer does the farmer sit on a stool and squirt milk into a pail. Machinery does the job today. Many cows can be milked at the same time. This speeds up the process, and the milk is never touched by human hands. Coming directly from the cow, through these tubes and pipes, the milk is pumped to a storage tank. There it's kept at a controlled temperature, and then it's transported by truck to the dairy. During the winter season, from November till May, dairy cows spend their time indoors in the barn. Now, this doesn't mean holiday time for the farmers. Dairy farmers are as busy as ever, feeding, washing, milking, every single day of the year. Christmas Day doesn't mean much to a cow. It might be a holiday for you and me, but not for the dairy farmer. Some farm animals live indoors all the time. Take pigs, for instance. There are many pig farms in Newfoundland. They produce millions of kilograms of pork and bacon. Oh, there's an occasional pig still kept in a sty out back of the barn, but the vast majority spend their entire lives indoors. The expression, dirty as a pig, doesn't mean much anymore, because these animals don't get a chance to wallow in the mud. On a modern pig farm, the pigs are really pampered. They're kept clean and warm and fed a carefully balanced diet. It's a very important part of our agricultural industry. Yes, piglets really are cute, but take a look at these. Now, what can be cuter than a baby chick? These tiny yellow balls of fluff are just a couple of days old, yet already they're able to scamper about on spindly legs and fill the barn with a chorus of peeps. Bruce helps his parents by feeding the chicks and making sure the room temperature is warm enough. A few months later, those little chicks are all grown up and gone to work. Some are bred for their meat, others to lay eggs. Newfoundland and Labrador hens lay millions of dozens of eggs per year. It's fascinating to watch the eggs being processed. They're gently picked up and then put down at the entrance to an egg washer. Hot water thoroughly cleans them as they are moved through. Notice that one section of the machinery is screened off with dark curtains. Inside, the eggs pass over a table where a strong light shows up any defects in them. Eggs that don't pass the test are removed. Continuing on, they're sorted according to weight. Near the end of the assembly line, they get put in the familiar egg cartons we all know. Finally, they're packaged for shipment to stores and supermarkets. Eventually, they'll wind up on our tables. When our grandparents were young, practically every family kept a flock of sheep. Money was scarce in those days, and sheep provided both meat for the table and wool for mitts and sweaters. There aren't nearly as many sheep in Newfoundland today. Roaming dogs, which often kill and maim sheep, have discouraged many sheep farmers. However, there are parts of Newfoundland where the raising of sheep is an important industry. And there are people who believe Newfoundland is an ideal place for sheep farming. We have a fairly mild climate and lots of rough, wild pasture on the coastline. Our sheep were brought here from England and Ireland hundreds of years ago. Other breeds have been introduced in more recent times. This handsome black-faced sheep is called a Suffolk. Nadia hopes he'll win a medal at the fall fair. This is a silver fox. Its coat is worth a lot of money. Because of the rapidly rising prices offered for fox fur in recent years, more and more Newfoundlanders have begun to raise these animals. The young foxes are kept outdoors in cages and are fed and watered daily. When they're mature and the furs are in perfect condition, the foxes are killed and the furs sold to make expensive coats and hats. Just about everybody loves strawberries, especially when you can pick them yourself. Many Newfoundland strawberry farmers open up their fields to the public. People come from all over to pick their own berries. The farmers charge by the basket as you leave the farm. It's a good arrangement. The farmer gets his crop picked. The pickers get their supply of strawberries for the freezer. And everyone enjoys a nice day in the country. Blueberries. Well, believe it or not, blueberries are farmed too. A good picker using a rake like this can pick as much as 100 liters of berries a day. The blueberry farmer burns over the land every second year. This makes the blueberries grow more abundantly. In the processing plant, the berries are washed, sorted, frozen, and packed, ready for shipment to the United States and sometimes to Europe. Not all our blueberries are sent out of the province, though. We Newfoundlanders like our blueberry jam, too, and our wild partridge berry jam. Our grocery shelves are full of Newfoundland products. Most of the eggs you see at your supermarket or store come from our own Newfoundland farms. So does most of the chicken we eat. The pork and bacon that comes from Newfoundland farms is of excellent quality. Our dairy farms produce most of the fresh milk we drink here in Newfoundland and Labrador. You know, having good quality milk and eggs and meat and vegetables always available is something we take for granted. We sometimes forget that these products don't just mysteriously appear. Someone has to produce them. Farming is a very important industry in our province. Our farmers contribute a lot to our economy. They create a lot of jobs. And they supply us with a great variety of fresh, nutritious, tasty food. So the next time you go to a supermarket or a grocery store, look at all the food on display and remember, most of it comes from our own land. Remember, farming is an important part of our way of life.